What are you doing still working? You're gonna be late.
For what?
The meeting with my teacher.
No, I won't. That's the day after tomorrow.
This is the day after tomorrow. Something should be more important than the farm, Dad. I've already called the McAllisters, so you better hurry. Come on, Dad.
Yeah. Relax. What's your problem? Just Dell.
But we should be ready when they get here.
What is this doing in here? If you want to play your guitar, play it in your room. I don't want to look at it.
It's them!
Morning there, Waylon.
Morning, Mr. McAllister.
Hey, you've been practicing.
Dad's been teaching me.
So, how's life on the farm?
Oh, well, Dad says she'll go 40 bushels if the weather holds.
Yeah, well, the whole country could use a bumper crop this year, eh?
Morning, Daphne. Appreciate the lift, Del.
Yeah, well, it's time to sell that old pickup for scrap, Jack.
Looking exactly what you used to be, no one's talking about scrapping you.
What?
Come on, Dad.
Okay. Guess the sooner we get there, the sooner I can get back.
Oh, you used to like going into town once in a while, you cranky old bugger.
Used to be you had some hair.
Well, come on, let's go. I gotta walk there by now.
Excuse me. Miss Simpson?
Mr. Tibbins, delighted to meet you.
I'm glad you could finally make it to one of our appointments.
I'm sorry about that. Had a few problems with my truck. So I guess you wanted to see me about Waylon, is that right?
About his guitar, actually. Now, I know you're a very musical family, and I don't want to discourage Waylon's talent. But he's falling behind in his homework.
Trust me, I'll put a quick stop to that.
Well, I don't mean destroy his guitar. I just need him to do his homework. Besides, I think it's great that the two of you have something you can do together.
I don't play. He just kind of picked it up on his own.
Oh, I was told that you were quite a musician.
Was there anything else?
Not really. Perhaps if you just spoke to him about the importance of having a well-rounded life.
Okay, I'll try. But I must warn you, I'm not really much of an expert in that area.
Yes, I've noticed.
What?
But you don't come to town very often. Anyways, class starts soon. Thanks again for stopping by.
Miss Simpson?
Hmm?
I really appreciate the concern that you're showing for my boy.
I'll see you at the ball game later.
No, I don't usually get to those. It's a bad time here for me.
Okay.
What time does it start?
See so many of you taking an interest in our vital civic affairs. Very gratified indeed.
It's all a hoopla.
All I know is we have to clap when my dad unveils his whatchamacallit.
For the Brunswick town of tomorrow. This project will go into effect immediately. Residential areas, a golf course, an industrial park. See, what this is a town plan. And a town with a plan is a town with a future.
Well, who's supposed to pay for all this?
Well, I'll be damned. My son-in-law, the hermit, is taking an interest in the future. Have you taken a look at the fields around here lately? This is going to be one of the most prosperous years in the history of our town.
Well, where's the school, Grandpa?
Well, the matter of the school's fate is still pretty much an open question.
Some people are saying that you're planning to send our children away.
Well, Dad, don't you think our kids deserve better than a ramshackle old building and a playground that just runs on out into the wheat fields? Now, how about some free ice cream? Don't shut up, kids. There's plenty to go around.
Hey, Waylon. Hey, Brad.
Oh, hey, guys, it's practice.
Baseball?
No, the band.
Sorry, guys, it's my shift at the grill.
Great. I guess that makes us a power duo.
All you want to do is practice. You need some fun in your life.
Like free ice cream.
Ice cream?
Yeah. Why not?
Guys, we're gonna look like idiots if we don't practice. I mean, to be taken seriously, we have to...
See you later at the ball game, unless you run off and get married or something.
Ice cream? Thanks.
We've got an exciting finish shaping up here as my son, Brad Morgan, tries to win the game for the town kids. Don't let me down, son. I got a fiver on you.
Yeah! Good try, Brad!
What you doing, Brad? Slapping mosquitoes? That's two down for the town kids. The farm kids ahead by two runs, but the bases are loaded and... Up the bat now is Daphne McAllister. Remember, folks, nobody can anticipate your fiduciary needs better than your local banker. See Dan Morgan on Main Street today for your financial peace of mind. Could I have your attention, please, for some exciting news from Mayor Dawkins?
Thank you, Dan. I want to take this opportunity, with so many of you gathered together in one place, to announce that I've just worked out a deal with the town of Lairdwood to accept the transfer of our children to their brand new school. The execution of our town plan will go ahead as scheduled. You hear that, kids? You're going away to school.
Miss Hinton, play ball. Up a big win for the town kids. Not that they got any help from my son, the strikeout king.
I want to talk to you about my grandson.
Look, I know you're disappointed, but it's not like I didn't name him Garth. But he does have a name.
I want to give him something that you can. A chance to make something of himself. Send him here instead of Lairdwood.
What's this? Davenport Academy, an education which offers young men of the highest caliber an entree into the inner circles of finance, law, and business.
Mm-hmm.
Are we rushing things here a little bit? It's just a kid.
It's never too early. Now I'll pay for the tuition and his expenses, and maybe I'll throw in a couple of visits.
What makes you think he wants to leave home?
Because you're a drunk. And a loser. And you can't take care of yourself, much less anybody else. And I owe it to the memory of my daughter to see your son has a shot at a decent life.
I haven't had a drink in 12 years, and you know.
Enjoy the game, Mr. Tibbetts?
Well, why don't you just call me Jack?
Okay.
Yeah, I had a great time. I had no idea that my son was, like, such an outstanding pitcher.
Well, unless he's pitching to a certain girl who seems to have caught his eye.
Yeah, I guess he's grown up quicker than I thought.
You strike out your best friend, and then you serve a ball on a platter to some girl?
That was my best pitch. You'd have never got a piece of it.
Well, we better find the ball or my dad'll pitch a fit.
It's nice to see you out. I'm sure Waylon appreciated it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Boy, it seems to take so much to get me off the farm these days. Used to travel around so much, too.
Was that before you got married?
Well, no. My wife and I were a team. And then Waylon and I took on the farm after she died.
I'm sorry.
You're all right. It was a long time ago now. Here you go. Who's taking those kids? Okay, Waylon, let's go!
Just forget it, man.
It's toast. Get it? It's in the wheat, so now it's toast? That's funny.
You hear anything, Dan?
Yeah. Interest accruing.
I hear the sound of wheat ripening in the hinterlands, and you know what that means.
A good crop.
A good crop for the tenant farmer means a cash flow to me, and a cash flow means money to invest, and investment means leverage, and leverage means...
prosperity.
Have a good one, Dan.
You too, Garth.
Waylon, stop playing that guitar. Come on down here.
Oh, morning, son. Hope you're hungry.
You made breakfast?
Yes, I did. Bacon and eggs. Eggs over easy, but they ended up kind of scrambled there, huh?
What's up?
What's up? What do you mean? I can't make my favorite son breakfast?
Sure.
Go ahead. So how's it going up there in grade 7?
Miss Simpson's the best.
You really like her, don't you?
I saw you two talking last night.
So?
So?
So? So we were just having a little parent-teacher chat about a certain person thinks more about his guitar and does not do his homework.
Oh.
Oh. The guitar is a hobby. Don't let it get in the way of real life. You hear me? Son. You hear that? Oh, yeah, also your grandfather. That's a little proposition for you. I think that you should see it.
A private school?
Very good school.
So that's why you made me breakfast. You want to get rid of me?
I want to get rid of you. I want what's best for you.
I want to stay here. I want things to stay the same.
Well, things just don't stay the same, son. You have to grow and you have to adapt.
You don't.
No, you hear that?
Yeah.
I can't believe this.
What are they?
Hoppers? So it's just a grasshopper, right?
Well, certainly. The way a piranha is just a fish. I've never seen anything like this, though, Jack.
Why?
Brown spots on its back, 2 extra antennae. Look at the ratio between his labrum and his mandible. Very odd. You're not playing some little joke on me, are you, Mr. Jack Tibbins?
As if I'd be joking.
Well, I'll wager it wasn't alone.
No, there was a swarm of them.
Mm.
What am I gonna do, Mirth? I mean, this is the best crop I've had in years.
Well, it won't be for long. Look at the masticators on that.
Where's this big hopper I've been hearing about?
Look.
My word.
What are you doing?
I'm simulating the release of DTG.
Is this stuff poisonous?
Oh, it's unpleasant, but it's not dangerous to humans.
Didn't seem to like the smell very much.
This is highly irregular.
Yeah, it seems like you got quite a buzz out of that.
Is this stuff going to work in the fields?
It would take weeks with a method like this.
Why?
We need people to light and fan the smudge pots, gauge the wind speed.
No problem. I mean, these are our farms, our crops we're talking about here. Let's just do stuff. Let's do it.
You're saying we should shut down the whole town?
Well, I suppose I could call a special meeting in a couple of days and we could discuss it.
Couple of days?
That's what I said.
It really doesn't matter to you, does it? The worse things are, the richer you get.
What are you trying to say?
Well, who holds most of the mortgages in the farms around here, Dan?
You know, that's private bank information, Jack.
You're trying to grab off more land at rock-bottom prices. People do notice.
I don't create these situations, Jack. I just have the wherewithal to roll with the punches.
Well, not this time. No, sir. Not this time.
Simpson?
In a minute, boys. The rest of you, that was really good. And the next time we go to do that, I would like you to start on...
Now, Miss Simpson?
Hold your horses. Sopranos. On that chorus, it's...
Can we start now, Miss Simpson?
Yes. Please do your song.
Ready, guys?
Yep.
A one, a two, three. Wait, hold it, guys. Miss Simpson?
What is it, Jack?
We have an emergency. I need all the kids to go home, get your parents, and then tell them meet me down at my farm, okay?
What's wrong?
There's a hopper swarm heading this way.
Grasshoppers? At this time of year?
Yeah. We seen them this morning, right, Waylon?
Yeah, there's great big ones. I mean, they were everywhere.
So if we can get as many people as we can, maybe we got a chance to drive them out of here.
Okay, children, do as Mr. Tibbin says. Go home and get your parents.
Thanks a lot. Thanks, Miss Simpson. Thanks a lot, kids.
It's not polite to stare, Mr. Tibbins.
Right.
Come on, Dad.
Right.
How much longer?
Well, no more grasshoppers, I guess.
I'm thirsty.
Got that right, Waylon.
Rolling home, come on, let him go! Fan, go! Fan, go!
Dad?
All right, forget it.
Okay, kill it! Oh, yes.
It was a good try, Jack. Couldn't have done anything better.
Just about everyone out to help.
Really? I think he had it in him. Or that he even cared.
Wind was too high, though, as you'd expect. Didn't work.
That didn't surprise me.
Gotta give him full marks for trying, though.
Jack is a loser. I knew that the first time Sally brought him home. Should have run him off then.
Harper's farm has settled right in over our farm. We're in big trouble now. There's no use pretending here.
Well, Grandpa's helped us out in the past.
Forget it. Won't happen.
Will we have to sell the farm?
Don't know.
Well, Grandpa could lend us some money. Hey!
I will never take a handout from that man. Do you understand me? I told you to leave that thing in your room. Don't leave it on the kitchen table.
My guitar! You broke my guitar!
Do you think a broken guitar constitutes trouble? Well, you have no idea what real trouble is in this world. This is a toy.
I saved for this guitar myself!
Nothing like the blues, is there?
Okay, what are you doing in my barn? How'd you get down here?
I was on the road, night came. You know how it is. You got a guitar around here? We could take a stroll on the Delta, you and me.
I don't play the guitar.
Oh, that's a crying shame.
Okay, look. I don't know who the hell you think you are or what you're doing down here, but I want you to leave.
Whatever you say, Jack.
How'd you know my name?
V, 1967. Is it yours?
Was.
Well, we'll play something for me.
No, I can't remember how to play this thing. Plus, you know, you're gonna have to put some strings on it and do a little work on it. But
where was it?
It was out in the barn with some other old stuff. Look, if you don't want it, I'll put it
no,
back in
no,
the...
No. Dad, this is the best thing anyone could give to me.
Dan?
I hear Jack's farm has taken a beating.
Oh, that's a darn shame, really.
You hear anything else? I hear a lot of support for your education initiatives.
Well, that's very sensible. The children are our future. They deserve the very best.
So I heard.
You have a good one, Dan.
You too, Garth.
Time for a little chat, Mayor.
You sure walk soft for such a determined type woman.
May I please buy you a cup of coffee? Won't cost you a nickel.
Oh, Missy, there ain't no such thing as a free cup of coffee. But, after you. Hey, hold it.
So what are you up to, sending my students to another school?
Well, surely you realize this is the best possible solution for everybody.
Oh, I'm sure it's the best for you in some way. But there's no way you're doing this for the children. You got some scheme that's going to put money back in your pocket.
Well, now, Missy. Oh, Jack, what brings you back here? Not thirsty, I hope.
Yeah.
Jack?
I just came by to see Mary. If you're finished here, maybe I can get you a cup of coffee out there, or there's some light.
What's the matter? You got no more brilliant plans on how to get rid of the hoppers?
Mr. Dawkin, you can't just sit back here forever and play with people's lives. Yesterday, Jack did his best to help. And people will remember that.
Things are sure weird lately. First those grasshoppers show up at the farm, and then Dad gives me a guitar. The Flying V's a classic. I mean, what's my dad doing with a guitar like that? Something the matter? Well, I like you too.
Separated if they close the school?
Doesn't matter. We'd still see each other. The deaf school? It's 1,000 miles away.
Hey,
I'm sorry.
If you're gonna be kissing pretty girls, kid, you better develop some kind of sense of balance.
You play?
Yeah, but I'm nowhere near as good as you.
Well, I've been playing a long time, kid.
...1959 Strat Sunburst. Nice axe.
Just between you and me, kid. Don't call it an axe unless you're being funny, okay? Don't worry. I don't bite. It's like a baby. Except it doesn't cry. It sings.
Do that. Can you teach me?
Better stay on your girlfriend's good side, kid. She's got a heck of a swing. See you around.
Oh. Hey, Tanya.
Mm-hmm?
Did we get a couple of coffees over here?
So are things as bad at your farm as I've heard?
May have to sell. The trouble is, the only person who could buy us out would be Garth, and I don't think he'll pay too much.
Would you leave?
Guess if we had to. I mean, we could go anywhere. I don't want to leave. I don't like the idea of like, just getting driven off like this. I've lived my whole life around here. What do you think will happen to you?
I don't know. I mean, Brunswick feels like my home now. I'm not gonna pack my bags and wave goodbye the way Mayor Dockin wants.
Nice to see you again, Jack.
Friend of yours?
No, I just threw him out of my barn this week, that's all.
I need a guitar man?
Oh, yeah, you need me.
Sure I do. Dan, get Mirth over here right away. We gotta do something about this mess of hoppers.
I'm sorry, but these aren't hoppers, Mayor. They're locusts.
These are locusts?
This is the Great Western Plains, not biblical times in Egypt.
Open your eyes, Mayor. Or even better, your ears. Listen. They're hungry. Only locusts get that hungry.
I hear it.
Yep. 667 hertz. That'd be the Schistocera diabolus. Worst of the worst. I'm afraid you're gonna need a miracle.
I don't think anybody believes in miracles around here, mister.
Even if one's standing right in front of you.
Maybe you ought to listen to him, Mayor.
Yeah. Well, why don't you show us what you're talking about? Dude.
cash or barter only for this guitar man.
$10,000?
Well, we only pay $5,000 up front. The other half, we pay if it works.
Oh, I don't know, Garth. I really think we're really reaching here.
You see the faces on those townspeople? They are desperate people. I'm their mayor. They expect me to do something about it. And I gotta say, Murph, so far you haven't been very much help.
Well, I had some success with a sledgehammer and a blowtorch.
That's not funny, Murph.
Well, what's bugging you two? This thing is bigger than both of us, Garth. These locusts or hoppers or whatever they may be are unstoppable. They're not insect.
Well, this here guitar man, he's megahertzing or something into popcorn. And I want to know, you think it's possible for him to do that to the whole lot of them?
Well, theoretically, I suppose, the vibrations of a certain pitch or magnitude reverberating in an elastic medium, especially over 20,000 hertz, could plausibly be enough of an irritant to cause an amalgam of adverse responses.
So, we're not completely outside the realm of scientific possibility.
But that would be a circus act. And we're dealing with science here, Garth. Now, let me do my work.
All right, sweetie, you just keep on trying. She just doesn't understand. I think she's a few bricks short of a full load. The only sin in politics is to do nothing.
Please, help us. We're in real trouble now.
Dan, don't worry. I know a win-win situation when I see one. Now, if this doesn't work, I'll be regarded as a mayor who stopped at nothing in a desperate attempt to save his town. If it does work, I'll be regarded as a visionary. I love politics.
Got one, Garth! Ooh.
So what an awesome guitar player that was. All the greats play like this. Someday, I'll be a guitar god. Page, Clapton, Hendrix, Tibbins. Maybe I'll have to change my name. Yeah, that'd be weird. I can't imagine living without music. You dream music? This is my dad and my mother. It says he came back to play a concert after a big national tour. Like my parents were professional musicians. Mom was killed in a car accident when I was 2. I don't really remember, and Dad doesn't like to talk about her much.
Some guitar guy's gonna blow up all the locusts.
Amplification unit can't be up to the challenge.
Don't worry, it'll do the job.
Afternoon, folks. Well, I hope we're going to see some wondrous things here today. Now, you don't have to tell me it sounds crazy. But he did SAS the small demonstration this afternoon, didn't he, Tanya?
Yeah, he turned them into popcorn.
And I know that some of you folks have heard that this here man with the guitar is going to charge us $10,000 to get rid of this modern plague. Well, I say it's worth it if you can do what he claims. You'll be either for action over inaction. That's why he elected me.
Half in advance, $5,000.
She'll hold it for me.
I should warn you, I don't believe in shamans or rainmakers.
That's fine. I'm none of those things. I'm a guitar man. You don't believe me? Ask Jack.
I don't know you. Look, I don't know this guy.
Well, folks, now, better stand back there. Because when these hoppers start to blow, things could get a bit messy.
They only do that inside. Out here, they just go away.
Away? Where?
Just away.
$10,000. And we have to listen to him play.
I detest this kind of music.
Brunswick, are you ready? Work with me now, I said. Brunswick, are you ready to rock and roll?
Yeah.
Are you ready for the jack jamming, rain making, play faster, rip faster?
Yeah.
Oh, feature this, children. The power of the finely tuned perfect note. The lost chord against the horde.
Yeah.
A pestilential retort from the big box of thunder in the sky. Can you dig it?
They're gone.
I do believe I'll take shelter from the storm.
Storm? What storm?
Locusts just vanish.
Well, if they really have disappeared, we shouldn't be hurt too bad, actually. Maybe lose a quarter section, that's about it. What do you think, Will?
Well, we always get top rate of the elevator anyways, so Dad knows how to work real smart.
It's not polite to go boasting like that.
It is permissible to boast about one's parent, Mr. Tibbins.
Oh, is that right, Miss Simpson? That's a little something they teach you up there at Teachers College, huh?
So, Would you like to come to dinner tonight?
Oh, don't look at me. Wynn's the cook.
Yeah, but he'd like it if you come. Wouldn't you, Dad?
Of course, yeah. That'd be great.
I'd be honored.
Oh, great! I mean, we don't get much company, and when we do, they never stay. Well, come on, let's get going. I'll start cooking.
All right, let's go.
Aren't you guys coming?
Not yet.
Yeah, we're right behind you, son. Just go ahead and get the truck warmed up, okay?
Okay.
Okay?
Okay.
That guitar man was quite remarkable.
Yeah, I guess you have to say that.
It's quite a life change. Musician, farmer.
Well, I was a farmer before.
Do you miss it?
You're kidding. I mean, what's the miss? Look at this out here.
I mean, still dancing, music, performing live on stage.
I had a boy to take care of. And, well, I'm a good farmer.
Yes, I've heard.
Yeah?
And you're a good father.
Oh, yeah. Let's just say I'm a good farmer. I'm gonna leave it at that.
Wynn's one of my favorite students.
I bet you say that to all the parents.
Oh, of course.
Especially the dads.
Yes.
Yeah.
I'd say you're doing very well. He's intelligent. He's independent.
Oh, yeah.
He's talented.
Well, he takes after his mom, I guess.
Seems to me you could give yourself some credit here.
This is an auspicious day in the history of Brunswick Town. Not only have we successfully repelled the threat of the grasshoppers, but we are executing a fiscally responsible plan for the better education of our children, our most important resource. By laying the groundwork for a project, which I think you'll agree, is liable to bring an infusion of capital into this area. I am very pleased to announce that within the month, renovations will begin on the old school to make a place for Dan, the Brunswick Showroom and Casino.
We're shutting down our school to make way for a casino?
A casino which will produce a direct infusion in the amount of six figures annually. Miss Simpson,
would you come up here, please? I want to thank you publicly for your dedication to our youngsters. I've arranged a transfer to a fine school.
It's all here in this envelope. I'm sure you'll find it's all in order.
Now!
Wait a minute. I have something to say. Excuse me. I have something to say to you people. What you're doing is wrong. This man has dressed this up so it looks sensible and right. But the fact is, you're sending your children away. You'll kill this place if you do that.
Your severance pays in the envelope, Miss Simpson.
Now I declare that this school is officially closed!
Well, that's pretty good. I don't know why you're tumbling down on that E string. If you want to try it with a slur, or some guys use a hammer. Pretty good.
I'll never get it.
Yeah, you will. It takes years. You got lots of time.
It was amazing, that guy. He's the best guitar player I've ever heard. Were you ever as good as him?
Who, me?
Yeah.
So what do you think? We're gonna get enough off this land to make it through another year?
It was like magic. I mean, you just played the hoppers away.
Yeah. Well, it's one thing to take a stupid guitar and make things disappear. It's another thing to make things stay.
It was that stupid guitar that saved your stupid crops.
Stupid crops? Is that what you really think, stupid crops? I suppose you also think stupid old farmer, too, huh?
Well, it sure ain't rock and roll.
Well, excuse me for disappointing you, son.
You weren't always a farmer. Why didn't you tell me?
Tell you what?
It's you and Mom.
Where'd you get this?
Daphne found it at the school. I don't get it. All I ever wanted to do was play the guitar. And then I find out my parents are professional musicians.
That was a long time ago.
Well, how could you just stop playing?
Because I did. All right? Look, I don't have to explain my life to anyone. Not even to you. I'm going to town. I don't know when I'll be back.
Hey, guys. Guess what song I'm playing. Okay, that one was a little too hard. How about this one? Okay, how about this song? Happy birthday?
What is it? No, whoa, no, you're going way too fast for me. Cut it out.
Okay, pretend they're cymbals.
Hey, this is our barn.
Jingle bells.
Your parents met at a dance in my barn? I said cut it out.
Why? She can't hear me. You could set a cannon off and she wouldn't be able to hear it.
Shut up, Brad.
Blind people can hear real well. Maybe Daphne can see in the dark.
Hey, Daphne, did you hear the one about... Oh, I guess not.
Hey, man, cut it out. We're just joking.
That's it. We're not friends anymore.
Nothing. It's okay. They're just acting like idiots.
Yeah, it's hard to imagine barn dances in here, isn't it? I don't get it. Why did he stop? You mean he gave up music for me?
He had a motherless child to take care of.
Motherless children got a hard time because their mother is gone.
Stage went there. People would come from all around and dance. Right where you're standing.
You were here?
Well, here and a million other places just like it. Doesn't really matter. Say, what do you suppose is down there?
What is this place? Has it always been here?
This is everything Jack left behind after your mother died. Including the booze.
This must have been where they practiced. They were getting offers from recording companies? How could he hide this from me?
He thinks rock and roll killed your mother. How could he go on?
Where
Where'd he go?
A casino? I guess Garth gets his way again.
Yeah, he did. Why'd he let him get away with it?
Hey, you realize this is my old desk?
It's Waylon's now.
Really? I guess we're gonna have to say it was Waylon's.
Jack Tibbins loves Sally Dawkins.
That's right.
What would she think, I wonder?
What would she think about what?
About Garth Dawkins sending her son away, about all of it. Everyone in town believes what Garth Dawkins says. That you were driving drunk that night.
Well, I wish I had been drunk. I wish to hell I had been drunk out of my mind. At least that I have an excuse. But I was just in a hurry. And I was in a big hurry all the time, and we had an accident. I wasn't taking care of it. Okay?
I've been transferred.
Oh, really? It's too bad.
Jack, I need to know something.
What?
How long is it gonna take?
How long is what gonna take?
How long is it gonna take before you stop pushing people away with something that happened 12 years ago?
Look, I don't really think it's any of your business what happened 12 years ago, okay? I'm sorry.
Soon I'll be gone. And not long after that, Waylon will be gone. And being alone is one hell of a sentence for an innocent man.
I am not an innocent man. Because of me, Waylon's grown up with no mother. No, I think you'd actually be better off going.
What do you hear, Mayor?
I hear the sound of the earth spinning on a well-greased axis and the universe unfolding like a crisp dollar bill.
Well, what I don't hear is the buzzing of locusts. You are right. It was well worth 10 grand to get rid of those hoppers.
We might have got an even better deal than we expected. It appears that this guitar man may have settled for a half fee. Maybe had a guilty conscience.
You were right. Every problem is an opportunity.
Have a good one, Dan.
You too, Garth.
Stuff works best when you drink it.
I know how this stuff works.
Been a few years since you've seen the inside of one of these joints, hey, Jack?
Yeah, too long. Oh, jeez.
Listen, I thought you were a tequila man.
I drank tequila when I was on the road.
Those were the days, eh?
Well, if it isn't my son-in-law and that rock and roll huckster sharing a bottle, isn't that sweet?
It's what we were, eh, Jack?
I've told you, I don't know you.
Play me something.
What?
What was that jump blues stride you used to play back in the old days? You know, I bet your Mary would like to hear that.
Just, if you could, leave me alone, all right?
You know, that boy of yours has good hands. You ever notice that?
George, shut up.
He's got some talent, you know, maybe he won't waste it. Pick up the guitar, Jack.
Why don't I buy you one for the road, sport?
No, thanks. I'll just settle up and move on.
Well, as to that, Way I see it, a big lightning storm came up and scared them hoppers away. Bit of luck, perhaps, but not something we should have to pay for.
We had a deal.
I'm of the scientific opinion that them hoppers left of their own accord.
It has nothing to do with science, Mayor. Besides, I drove them away after you contracted me to do so.
You got a copy of this here contract? Listen, friend. You know who you are. And I know what you are. Now, why don't you consider yourself ahead of the game and get out of here before I call the police?
You're making a big mistake.
And you seem to only have a rudimentary understanding of your situation here.
My situation is that you owe me. You believe this, Welcher Jack?
Hey, don't talk to me like I'm some friend of yours. I tell you, I don't know you.
And you all agree with your mayor that I shouldn't be paid for services rendered?
It would seem that you have your answer.
You owe me. Jack, you know this is wrong.
Shut up.
Dad?
Can I have my guitar, please?
Yeah. Want your guitar? Huh? You tell me all night. Pick up your guitar. I picked it up. Here you go. Here it is.
Dad, don't! Jack!
Rock and roll.
You shouldn't have done that.
Okay, everybody, shooters on me.
Come on, get out of here. We told you nobody wants you around here.
Please, Dad. Let's just go home.
I'll be alone, boy. Just leave me alone, boy. Go ahead.
Give you something.
Jack's guitar.
He gave it to me.
Flying V. Very serious instrument. Guitar for moving the masses.
Take it. It's yours.
Kick it. Now I'm gonna do you a favor.
Never had to come pick me up, you know.
I've had too much to drink, but no one can tell you nothing, can they?
You got that right.
What you got in the bag, Jack? Planning on drinking this all by your loony self?
Maybe. I don't think I have fully decided at this point.
We were wild. Driving one crazy town to the next, drinking all night to stay awake. Who drinks all night to stay awake?
I guess we did.
Sally never did, though. Look, Jack. I know you miss Sally. We all do, but it's time to get on with the rest of your life. You gotta teach Waylon what you know.
I don't.
How are you gonna explain what you did tonight to that guy's guitar?
Find my bottle.
Jack, how are you gonna explain it?
Just give it to me, all right? Night, Del.
Well?
What?
About that guitar player.
Are you drunk? Were you drunk when you broke his guitar?
Come on, you know better than ask me that.
And I guess you weren't drunk the night that Mom died either.
No, I wasn't drunk.
Everyone says it. Everyone in town does. Why don't you tell me these things? Why don't you tell me the truth?
I was gonna tell you everything happened that night, but I was just gonna wait until you got a little older.
I'm going to the Davenport Academy. Grandpa says he'll take me whenever I want. You don't even have to leave the farm.
Here's to Brunswick Town. Locusts all gone, much needed rain shower, and good times on the way.
Good times. Good times.
Woke up this morning to see my little child was gone. Oh, yeah.
Waylon?
Let me begin by saying we really don't believe that over 30 children can simply disappear. Now, with that in mind, I'll tell you what measures we're taking to find your children. We've set up roadblocks, we've alerted the general public, and even though no one has as yet identified the abductor from our files, we feel sure that he will be brought to justice. Now I'll try to answer any questions you might have about the investigation.
I know how you're feeling. I too have lost a child. The pain is overwhelming. The sense of loss is so profound. And you can never be the same again. And your heart breaks. But we are a strong people. In this town, we've seen through disasters, drought, hail, infestation, and disease, and we have prevailed. And do you know why? Because we know that life can begin again tomorrow. When things are at their worst and we are beaten, we know we can plant again tomorrow. Push aside the pain and pick up the pieces because we know that we will feel better again tomorrow.
No. No. That's wrong. Garth, nobody knows that better than you and me. Nobody in this town. I'm tired of waiting for tomorrow.
You've been drinking again. You're drunk.
I'm not drunk. I don't know what I am, but I feel sober for the first time in 12 years.
That's right. You run back to your farm. Leave this to people who care about their community.
We should have paid that Guitarman guard.
We all want them to come back.
Mary. Good. I was worried I was too late.
Way too late. Why are you here? What do you want from me?
I want you to stay.
Why would I do that?
Look, please, Mary, don't just disappear. I've allowed so much to vanish. And now on top of everything else, my son. I gotta put an end to it, so I'm asking you. Will you stay?
For what? I'm a teacher. And in this whole town, there's only one student.
Well, what if I were to tell you we're gonna open up this school again?
What? Why?
Because it's the right thing to do. Will you stay?
Okay.
Good answer. Teacher.
Jack? Jack?
Daphne tells me you're gonna fix the school.
That's right. You come to talk to me out of it, you can forget it.
No. Look, we brought a block and tackle.
Got her, Jack?
Shouldn't we test it out?
Not yet. Hope we finish.
Hello, Jack?
God only knows why we try and fail. Is this heaven on earth or the fires of hell? Try to be honest, it's hard not to lie. Will you remember?
I can't remember saying a single thing to Gordy that wasn't in order. I'm afraid that wherever he is, he doesn't know how much I loved him. Will you how cheerful he was, and that grin.
He was?
He never seemed to smile very much.
Now that Brad Morgan was a pretty funny boy. He sure did a terrific imitation of the mayor.
My Brad. He hardly ever opened his mouth at home. Not that he ever really had a chance.
What do you want here, Dan? The mayor sent a message with you?
I got a load of new hardwood flooring, and I used to have a son too.
Will you remember me? Will you remember me? Will you remember me? Will you remember me? Will you remember me?
Looks good.
How could we have been so blind?
Will you remember me?
I've been watching you people. I've been watching you wasting your money and your time on a useless gesture. I thought maybe it was some kind of therapy you all needed. But you people have accomplished is you've built a monument to the past. Now take it from me. You have got to tear down the past and build for the future.
No, we're building for today. Our children should not be considered some kind of resource for the future. Their childhood is only a brief, precious time. And we owe them that.
Don't listen to him. Now, which one of you is gonna take the first step? Come up here and put this crowbar into this monument of sadness and defeat. Dan, get up here. All right. I can see that it's going to be up to me, your elected leader, to take the first step. Well, that's what you elected me for, to take action. And I'm not afraid to do it. What are you all staring at? It's me, Garth Dawkins. I've had it with you people.
Well, I'll do it myself.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms. But when I woke, dear, I was mistaken, and I hung my head and cried. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are.
Or barter. Those are my terms.
We'll get you your money. Hey, Dan. Dan!
Here are the keys to the bank. Take them. Take all the money you need.
Cash won't cut it anymore. Thanks, kid. It's really not my style.
You'll need a guitar, right?
Any requests, Mr. Mayor?
The hell with a lot of you.
Oh. You remember me now, Jack?
You seem kind of familiar.
Then we're all square.
Well, the other night,
I dreamed I held you in my arms. But when I woke, dear, I was mistaken, and I hung